Welcome back. We're talking now with Kendall Dunkelberg from the Mississippi University for Women, here to tell us about the Eudora Welty Writers Symposium and Gala, which is coming up. Good morning, Kendall. Thanks for being here.
Good morning. Great to be here. We're going to be next week, starting Thursday at 7:30 p.m. with our keynote author, Ralph Eubanks,
okay.
And his book, A Place Like Mississippi. We'll have 11 other writers throughout the weekend.
Very cool. What is the idea behind the symposium? I know this isn't the first year that you guys have done it. What was sort of the idea to get it started?
I believe it started as a celebration of one of our presidents, the first woman
okay.
president, Clyde Arendt, and it's been going for 33 years. This is our
wow.
33rd annual Eudora Welty Writers Symposium. We each year bring a dozen writers, Southern writers, to our campus, except for last year when we were all virtual.
Sure. Yeah.
But we're glad to be coming back together on campus this year. Our theme is All They Saw Was at the Point of Coming Together.
Mm-hmm.
And so we were hoping, optimistic, that we'd be able to bring our writers to campus. And as it turned out, we're able to do so this year.
I'm glad that it worked out like that. How do you go about selecting writers for this event? I know you mentioned that they're all from the South or generally this area. That's a big factor.
You know, we have a number of local writers this year. Thomas Richardson, who went through our MFA program at the W and also taught at New Hope High School, will be launching his or reading from his debut poetry collection on Saturday morning. Becky Hagenston from Mississippi State University will be reading from her collection of short stories, The Age of Discovery. And Lee Durkee from Oxford, Mississippi will read his second novel, his second novel, The Last Taxi Driver. So we have both local people and people from around the state, and then we reach out to the region. It's a matter of keeping track of who's come to the symposium, who are their friends,
right.
Trying to get suggestions from our faculty, from other writers, and find out who are the Southern writers with new books this year.
A lot of networking, I imagine, in there.
Yeah,
for sure. Yeah. What time does everything start, or do people need to get tickets ahead of time? How does that work?
So we are asking this year, because of COVID, that people RSVP.
Okay.
People can go to mew.edu/welty. There's a link to our RSVP form, and you just fill out a couple of brief information about how many in your party and that kind of thing, so we can tell, are we going to fill up Whitfield Hall's Rent Auditorium? It seats 1,000, but we're going to try to put about 200 or so in there, so we'll be kind of watching that.
Mm-hmm.
But there's no cost to come to the symposium.
Okay.
You can come down, and if you don't RSVP, we'll see if we have room for you.
You'll try your best.
We'll try to let you in. I think we'll probably have room for everyone. So they can come, but it's great if they can RSVP. We do ask people to be masked during the symposium.
Sure.
We are going to have some refreshments, and we're hoping the weather's going to be nice so we can be outdoors for some of that part of it during our breaks.
Yeah.
But we start 7:30 p.m. on October 21st
okay.
for the keynote. 9 o'clock on Friday morning, 1:30 in the afternoon for afternoon session, which has the ephemera prize with 5 high school prize winners. And 9:30 on Saturday morning.
Go ahead.
There's also the Welty Gala, which is a fundraiser, and for that you need tickets and you need to talk to the MUW Foundation. I don't handle any of that, but that's Friday evening starting at 7 p.m.
Okay. Who would benefit most from the symposium, do you feel like? Is it students? Is it people wanting to be writers? What are your thoughts on that?
Really, it's for readers.
Okay.
So you don't have to want to be a writer, but it's great if you do. There's time for Q&A, so time to be able to ask all these writers, how do they write, when do they write, how do they get their work published,
sure.
and all that kind of good thing as well.
A lot of interesting stuff. Kendall, thanks so much for being here this morning.
Great to have you.
All right, we'll be right back.